This is Lee Enochs, and this is the Lee Enochs Show, America's most controversial podcast, coming to you live from UNT. This is KNTU Radio. I hope you guys had a great Thanksgiving break. It's been a couple weeks since I did my last podcast. Took a week off for Thanksgiving. Hope you guys enjoyed your Thanksgiving break. I know I did. Tonight we're going to talk about the problem with woke Christianity. Over the last couple of years, there's been a lot of discussion about woke ideology in American culture. A lot of conservatives have had a problem with woke ideology infiltrating the schools, the U.S. military, the corporate world. We see it all around us. Recently, former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has been addressing the issue of wokeism, which is ultimately liberal social justice ideology being forced upon the U.S. military and all its branches, the curriculum that's being taught to our service women and service men, embraces wokeism. Now, what is woke ideology or wokeism? Well, the term woke is taken from the word awoken or awake. Basically, people that are woke are those who are aware, who have come to realize the issue of social justice, institutional racism, and whatnot. It really came into play a couple of years ago during the George Floyd protests. Some people call them riots. But ultimately, the Black Lives Matter controversy of 2020, when there were a lot of buildings being burned down and whatnot, there were people that supported Black Lives Matter, or BLM. And there was a lot of discussion about rectifying institutional racism throughout society and all its institutions. There are some people that want to tear down most of the institutions in the United States due to perceived racism and discrimination against people of color over the centuries. Today, though, I want to talk about the issue of woke Christianity or woke theology. Like some of the institutions in America today, including the military, our public schools, the corporate world, many churches in America have embraced wokeism or woke ideology. And it went woke. They are crying out for social justice. They want to eliminate discrimination and racism. But it's not just that. There are a lot of churches now that are embracing elements of cultural Marxism, ideologies that are antithetical to Christianity. Case in point, in Cambridge, England last week, a researcher basically talked about how Jesus Christ is transgender, and that Jesus Christ's wound on his side was kind of like a bleeding genitalia. And people were walking out of that service there at Cambridge University of Cambridge chapel, walking out of there crying and just stunned and offended by the incorporation of that radical of ideology. As I spoke about several weeks ago in my message, A Letter to a Woke Church, the problem with woke ideology coming into Christianity is that ultimately it's a backdoor to liberalism. Many churches have unwittingly embraced theological liberalism and now are challenging traditional doctrines of the Christian faith. We have to be really concerned about the issue of wokeism and woke Christianity. A lot of people are discarding historic Christianity and embracing tenets of woke ideology, leftism, cultural Marxism. You got to remember, Marxism is antithetical to Christianity. Karl Marx said that Christianity and religion is the opiate of the masses. He completely repudiated any understanding of Christianity. The public schools in our country, the military, the corporate world are all embracing wokeism. And now the church is embracing elements of woke ideology. They're being awakened to social justice issues. There are many people in the Christian world today in the United States that are now open to different versions of sexuality, different ideas concerning what it means to be a man, what it means to be a woman, and are embracing multiple genders. And this is coming into the Christian church. There should be concern against issues of racism. Christians should be on the forefront of repudiating any kind of racism. But we should not embrace elements of ideological progressivism that is contrary to Christianity. The Bible says, beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the traditions of the world, not according to Christ, for in him dwells the fullness of the Godhead bodily. The Bible says, examine everything carefully and hold fast what is true. In Acts 17:11, it says that the people of Berea were more noble-minded than those in Thessalonica, and they received the word of God of all readiness, and they searched the scriptures daily to see if these things were so. We have to be Christians as evangelicals, as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end, to not embrace cultural Marxism, not to embrace, without critical evaluation, woke ideology. This is Lee Enochs, and this is the Lee Enochs Show, America's most controversial podcast, saying it's important not to embrace woke Christianity because really it's just an inroad and a gateway to theological liberalism, a repudiation of the authority of Scripture, a denial of the Word of God, an undermining of the historic concept of the Trinity, that there's one God, and God exists, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. God sent Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins, was buried, and rose again from the dead. Many people that support woke ideology also are pluralists that believe there are many ways to heaven, many different roads to salvation, many different paths to authentic spirituality. But Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father but through me. The book of Acts chapter 4, verse 12 says, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name given amongst men by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ is the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and last, who was and is to come, the Lord God Almighty. He died on the cross for our sins, was buried, and rose again from the dead. My friends, test the spirits, whether it be of God, for many false prophets have gone out into the world. I'm afraid that elements of woke ideology are antithetical to historic Christianity. The Bible alone is the Word of God, not cultural Marxism, not progressive ideology. We as Christians need to repudiate anything that's contrary to Scripture and return back to the authority of Scripture alone. This is Lee Enochs, and this is the Lee Enochs Show, America's most controversial podcast, signing out. God bless you, and have a great night.